Jacob Cave has asked us how to paint the horns of a Stardrake. And today we're going to show you a great method of doing this that not only is good for the horns, but also the teeth and claws as well. Now to do this, you need to start from a base coat of Mechanica Standard Grey. And you can start from an undercoat of this colour, which is the perfect beginning for it. But if you've been painting other details in your Stardrake first, like how we have done, you'll need to neaten up the horns before you begin this process. But then for the actual scheme of the horns, what you need is Dawnstone first of all to make them a little bit lighter towards the base, and then we're going to shade them using Norm oil, and we're going to be applying multiple coats of this to make them a little bit darker towards the tips. Now once that's done, we'll start highlighting first of all with Dawnstone once more, and then after that we'll finish them off with Screaming Skull. But we're going to start out with Dawnstone, which I'm going to be applying using my medium layer brush, and what we want to do here is thin the paint down a little bit more than we normally would to really get that transparency from the layer paints. So add quite a bit of water in there, like this, and you're looking to get to about this kind of consistency. You can see it's very transparent and quite runny. Make sure your brush isn't overloaded before you start to apply it, and what we want to do here is start to paint along the length of the horns. So what I find is a comfortable way of doing this is to turn it so I'm painting vertically downwards like this, and I start applying the paint in lines with a kind of flicking motion like this. And doing this, you can see kind of builds it up as lines that fade out as we get further down. Now I want the colour to get a little bit stronger towards the actual base of the horn, so what I'll do is let this coat dry and then apply a second coat in exactly the same way, just a little bit further down towards the base of them to make it a little bit lighter there. But you can see I'm going roughly a quarter to a third of the way up the horns with this coat. Once you've finished with Dawnstone, you're then ready to move on to Norn oil to start to shade down the ends of the horns. Now what you want to do here is to apply a coat of Norn oil roughly halfway up the horn, so around to about this point here, and then whilst the shade is still wet, quickly get the excess off your brush with some tissue and just bring that shade down onto the lighter grey like that, so that it fades out like that. Once the shade's completely dry, you're now ready to add a second coat of Norn oil, and we're going to follow the same technique here, only a little bit further up towards the tips of the horns like this. So once again, paint some on, and whilst it's still wet, get the excess paint off your brush and just draw that still wet paint down like that, so it just fades out onto the colour beneath. Now during this step, you also want to add a little bit more Norn oil, but this time with a small layer brush for a bit more control, because we also need to shade around the very base of the horns around here. So just run it into the recesses like this, and those recessed ridges too. Now from this point on, it's really up to you how many more coats of Norn oil you add onto the actual horns. And bear in mind, each further coat you add will bring them close towards the black towards the tip. So it's really just a matter of taste. I've finished applying the Norn oil now, and I went for four coats in total, and you can see just how dark the horns have got towards the ends of them. And with that done, we're now ready to start highlighting. So for this, we're going back to Dawnstone first of all, applied with a small airbrush this time, and what we're going to do is apply an edge highlight following along all the sharp ridges of the horns, just like this. Once you've finished applying that highlight, you're ready to move on to the second highlight. Now this one's Screaming Skull, and this needs to be focused towards the base of the horns where the bone is lighter, so you're looking at painting along here, going up to the Dawnstone highlight. Leave the Dawnstone highlight though across the darker areas, but go back to Screaming Skull on the very tips, just a very small amount like this. And with that highlight applied, the horns are complete. And remember, you can use this method to paint all the claws and the teeth as well. So, Jacob, I really hope that helps you out when you're painting your Stardrake, and we'll see you all again very soon.